Thanks for watching. This is Ben Lyle in Scotland. I'm using 15x11 Fabriano watercolour paper, which is clipped to a piece of plywood on my easel. It weighs £130. I'm using my usual palettes. I've got Raw Sienna, Burnt Umber, Light Red, Ultramarine, Lemon Yellow, Payne's Grey, and Alizarin Crimson. I'm using, this is the large Ron Ranson hake brush. I've also got a 3/4 inch flat brush. I won't be using that for this painting. And the number 3 rigger, which will make a brief appearance. So I've wet the paper all over, just put on a very weak raw sienna wash, and then ultramarine right the way down to the bottom, using the same as colours as the sky. I've put in the distant mountain. And then you can see the colour just warming up slightly as you come forward in the scene. Just very simple strokes. I'm trying not to go over the same piece of paper more than once. Cause if you go over it just the once, you get all these nice little misty little areas and. So coming, I've warmed it up even more coming down on this right hand side with a bit of light red. Careful not to overdo it with the light red though, it's such a strong colour. Coming over to the left hand side now, a bit similar mix. It's just various mixes of raw sienna, light red, touch of ultramarine, lemon yellow. Just working my way down into the middle and foreground. I'm going to put some trees, some distant trees there in the middle ground. So I'm using lemon yellow and plenty of Payne's Grey to make those trees stand out, although I don't want to do them too dark being so far away. Your darkest tone should be in the foreground to help create with that sense of depth, the illusion of distance in your painting. So this is just simple trees going in, mainly with the corner of the hake brush, trying to keep it fairly straight at the bottom. A few more on the other side. And then a few more going up the hill on that far side again, just the corner of the hake, mainly lemon yellow. Payne's Grey to make a really rich greeny colour right up that hill there. I'm just going to pull the paper tight, refix it there on the right hand side. Because I wet it all over, it's stretched evenly, so it stops that cockling horrible effect that you get when you're using the thinner papers. So that's the distant hills in. Just working on the middle ground now. This is Raw Sienna on the brush. Such a burnt umber. And a bit of lemon yellow. Just keep varying it. Trying to keep it interesting. Just working my way down to where the stream will be. So these will be the bushes and whatnot just on the far bank of the stream. Just strengthening it there, a bit of burnt umber. Just strengthening the area where the land meets the water. I want to put the water in now, so clean brush, ultramarine, and then just some quick sweeps just to suggest the water and a few little splashes here and there. It helps if you just leave little gaps on the paper, just to leave little white areas, just to suggest those splashes. And this is now the foreground going in. Again, it's just various mixes, lemon yellow, ultramarine, raw sienna. There's going to be a tree, big tree on this left hand side, so lemon yellow, lots of Payne's grey, nice dark green. I'm just using the very corner of the hake, work your way down the tree trunk to suggest a big, big tree. A few flicks with the fingernail to suggest a few branches here and there. Try not to overdo it. And I'm going to put a fence. I'm going to put some fence posts in. So I want a nice dark background to put these fence posts up against. I'm just going to scrape them in with my finger. So I'm making sure this area along here is nice and dark, so it will contrast well when I put the fence posts in. You'll actually be able to see them clearly. Again, it's mainly the corner of the eye. Just bashing in a few bushes and whatnot here and there. Now these are the fence posts, just using the fingernail. A few leaning one way, a few leaning the other, just rickety old posts. Just start trying to add a bit of character to the picture. Don't do them all perfectly vertical, it just look boring. And then just very lightly, few connecting pieces here and there. That's just a very simple fence. I'm just switching to the number 3 rigger now. And by the tree and that fence, I'm just going to flick in a few more. Few more twigs and branches and grasses and reeds, and could be anything really. try not to overdo it. And as with most things in painting, keeping it subtle, it's always best if you just keep things subtle, just a little bit here and there, whatever it may be. It's so easy to overdo it, especially with watercolours. I mean, oils, you can just paint straight over anything you don't like. Watercolours, you're not really, you don't really have that luxury. So all I've got to do now is put the foreground in again, just varying the colour, a few quick sweeps, and it's in no time. Few more dibs and dabs here and there, just as it could be little bits of grass. I'm just going to give that a quick dry now with the hairdryer. We've just about got to finish painting. All that's left to do is number 3 rigger, dark colour, and put your signature in. And there we go. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.